The Holman Christian Standard Bible, 2 Corinthians, Chapter 1. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by God's will, and Timothy our brother, to God's church at Corinth, with all the saints who are throughout Achaia, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all comfort. He comforts us in all our affliction, so that we may be able to comfort those who are in any kind of affliction, through the comfort we ourselves receive from God. For as the sufferings of Christ overflow to us, so through Christ our comfort also overflows. If we are afflicted, it is for your comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is for your comfort, which is experienced in your endurance of the same sufferings that we suffer. And our hope for you is firm, because we know that as you share in the sufferings, so you will share in the comfort. For we don't want you to be unaware, brothers, of our affliction that took place in Asia. We were completely overwhelmed, beyond our strength, so that we even despaired of life. Indeed, we personally had a death sentence within ourselves, so that we would not trust in ourselves, but in God who raises the dead. He has delivered us from such a terrible death, and He will deliver us. We have put our hope in Him that He will deliver us again, while you join in helping us by your prayers. Then many will give thanks on our behalf for the gift that came to us through the prayers of many. For this is our confidence. The testimony of our conscience is that we have conducted ourselves in the world, and especially toward you, with God-given sincerity and purity, not by fleshly wisdom, but by God's grace. Now we are writing nothing to you other than what you can read and also understand. I hope you will understand completely, as you have partially understood us, that we are your reason for pride, as you are ours, in the day of our Lord Jesus. I planned with this confidence to come to you first, so you could have a double benefit, and to go on to Macedonia with your help, then come to you again from Macedonia, and be given a start by you on my journey to Judea. So when I planned this, was I irresponsible? Or what I plan, do I plan in a purely human way, so that I say yes, yes, and no, no simultaneously? As God is faithful, our message to you is not yes and no. For the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who was preached among you by us, by me and Silvanus and Timothy, did not become yes and no. On the contrary, a final yes has come in Him. For every one of God's promises is yes in Him. Therefore, the Amen is also spoken through Him by us for God's glory. Now it is God who strengthens us with you in Christ, and has anointed us. He has also sealed us and given us the Spirit as a down payment in our hearts. I call on God as a witness on my life that it was to spare you that I did not come to Corinth. I do not mean that we have control of your faith, but we are workers with you for your joy, because you stand by faith. 2 Corinthians, Chapter 2. In fact, I made up my mind about this. I would not come to you on another painful visit. For if I cause you pain, then who will cheer me other than the one being hurt by me? I wrote this very thing so that when I came I wouldn't have pain from those who ought to give me joy, because I am confident about all of you that my joy will also be yours. For I wrote to you with many tears, out of an extremely troubled and anguished heart, not that you should be hurt, but that you should know the abundant love I have for you. If anyone has caused pain, he has caused pain not so much to me, but to some degree, not to exaggerate, to all of you. The punishment inflicted by the majority is sufficient for that person. As a result, you should instead forgive and comfort him. Otherwise, this one may be overwhelmed by excessive grief. Therefore, I urge you to reaffirm your love to him. I wrote for this purpose, to test your character, to see if you are obedient in everything. If you forgive anyone, I do too. For what I have forgiven, if I have forgiven anything, it is for you in the presence of Christ. I have done this so that we may not be taken advantage of by Satan.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.